Get ready to match the stars. Don Galloway, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Riley, from Barnaby Jones, Lee Merriweather, Bill Daly, and Patty Doyle, as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 79. And now, here's the star of Match Game 79, Gene Rayburn.
Okay. For my first number. Okay. Are you ready? Are you ready?
I'm ready.
Yes.
All set.
You change your dress.
Yes.
Well, it's a new day.
Oh,
it's a new day. It's a new day.
Okay. I guess you're ready.
She has absolutely no musical talent whatsoever.
Has good pitch.
No, she doesn't have good pitch.
I do have good pitch. Tell
There's him, nothing Hodge. Going for her in that area, and she should face it. Do you know what I'm saying?
I know what you're saying.
It just gets me. Every
I think you're ready
for
a
afternoon.
Little
I'm here for
hiatus.
6 years.
Charles.
What?
You're ready for a hiatus. And you'll be taking one soon.
Definitely.
Now, here we have Ambie Charles and Shyla Anderson. Would you greet them, please? Ambie's the current champ with $6,200. She's done very well here. She's very happy about that. And how are we doing in this game? We're in the beginning of round two, and it's 3-0 favor the champ. Well, let's go to round two here and see if Shyla can catch up.
B, please.
B it is. Did you hear about Irving the Nut?
No.
I shall tell you about Irving the Nut. He took out flight insurance because he thought he was a blank. Irving the Nut took out flight insurance because he thought he was a blank. All right, now we're all set for Shyla Anderson. Irving the Nut here, Shyla. He took out flight insurance because he thought he was a blank.
A bird?
Bird, certainly. All that, is there? Little bird? Little bird for Shyla there?
You know, I thought about that.
And simple, got, straightforward, and what do you think?
Maybe this is a match. Cuckoo? Yeah.
Cuckoo!
Yeah. I was scratching his head. Okay.
Cuckoo bird.
Right, sweetheart.
I am surrounded by cuckoo birds. Yes. Yes.
You say that with this group.
Easy.
Now, I thought he was really a goofo. I mean, I thought he was really out of it. A bird is just, a lot of people think that. He thought he was a stewardess.
A stewardess. All right.
This is a match. I'm sorry. I have to say that.
Okay, you say it up front, right?
Bird.
Yes. Give it to him. I thought I heard a buzz there for a second.
Did hear a buzz. These people are going nuts here.
They are. Well, they are. They're in the same league with Irving the Nut there. Okay, Lee. Irving the Nut took out flight insurance because he thought he was a...
Well, if cuckoo is a match...
Yes.
Eagle certainly must be.
Yes, indeed.
He's very patriotic.
Yes. She's catching up.
I was going to say titmouse, but I thought that would be a little more specific.
What's funny about that?
It's a very well-known bird.
Of
indeed
it is.
But I thought that, I want to be more specific, so I said bird.
Okay. Four for Shyla. Now, let's see if we make it five. No, I guess we don't. When I get a I know we don't make it five.
I said a cumulus cloud.
Cumulus cloud. That floats on high o'er hill and dale.
That too.
When all at once I saw a crowd, a host of golden daffodils. 4-3 is the score. Favor of Shyla and Ambie. You'll have a chance to catch up and maybe pass her a little bit later. Now this. Here we go. Last chance, Ambie. Ready?
Yeah.
1 to tie, 2 to win. Here we go. Harry said at the political rally, "That last speaker was so boring, even the podium blanked." You don't write. Just the upper tier, as a matter of fact.
Good. Correct.
Yes. But I don't know if
Andy. Harry said at the political rally, "That last speaker was so boring, even the podium blanked."
Fell asleep.
You're going to say what?
Yawned. Yeah.
She said her first thought was yawned, and then she changed it to fell asleep, so that's her answer.
Well, I thought about that. I got to, I don't know, I put laid down.
Lay down. All right.
Sorry.
Okay. What do you?
All is not lost.
Right.
There are many people here who know how to play this game.
Name one.
Not at all.
Not at all. Tie score. Good. Charles, the whole responsibility rests with you. Does a game end in a tie or a win?
Stay tuned tomorrow.
Well,
it's not a
I was going to...
Don't.
Isn't wreck. She got a big mouth?
You must do that because that destroys the anticipation.
I was
going
to say yawn, and then I said fell asleep.
Okay. So, take your little spot there if you would, please. And we'll say goodbye to Shyla Anderson. It was a pleasure to meet you.
Barely.
And we'll send some gifts to you from Match Game 79.
Thank you.
Shyla Anderson. Here you go again. We have three wins here and $6,300. Let's see how far you go now. We polled the studio audience and said, write down your best answer to this. Do as blank. 500, remember, for matching the most popular, 250 for the second most popular, and 100 for the third. And three of the six ding-a-lings will help you here.
Charles, can I ask you again?
Do as I do.
Do as I do.
Lee? Do as your mother tells you.
Do as your mother tells you.
Okay. Great.
I know.
Now, this is a piece of advice my children have never taken, I must admit. Do as I say.
Do as I say. Do as I say, do as your mother tells you, and do as I do. You have the option now of choosing one of those or dreaming up one of your own and using that.
It's do as I say.
Do as I say. That was Brett's answer. Okay. How about do not as I do, but as I tell ye to? Remember
yes,
that?
Yes, sir.
Oh, all right. That may be up there. Who
there
knows?
There were no biblical scholars here that
well,
day.
Well, there might have been that day. All right, let's take a look at the $100 number and see what we have there. Do as you please.
Uh-oh.
Do as
that's
I
a permissive
say is what
audience.
We want. Let's look at the next one, please. Do as I say. You've got it. Congratulations. $250 more. What do you think's under the big one?
Do as the birds do.
Do as the birds do, do? You guys are crazy out there. All right, slide it, Ori. Do as I do. Do as I do is Charles' answer there.
Yeah.
Okay, now listen, you won the 250, means the least you'll play for is 2,500. But again, you'll spin the wheel and see if you can double it and play for $5,000. Good luck. Here we go. One revolution. That thing is really well lubricated, isn't it? It slides around there like crazy there. You're playing with Charles N. Riley. Here we go. And good luck to you. It says, blank tut, T-U-T. Now, wait a minute. Just don't give her any answers because it may be the wrong one. Okay. I'll tell you what I'm laughing at later. Save that. Yeah. If you give us the answer now that Charles has written on a card, you get $2,500.
King.
King Charles. Okay, Charles, she says King Tut.
I was going to write, tut tut.
Tut tut.
And then nip and tut.
Nip and tut.
But I thought of all those fake, ugly, materialistic things that they're forcing people to go in and see.
Yes.
All copies, all fakes. Send your letters directly here.
Pass that card over here. Let me see that here. Look at the answer that Patty Deutsch had there is Queen Tut. You really are a coot. Okay, you got $9,050. There's a souvenir card that won for you with Charles' signature on it, and you'll meet another player in a moment or so, but right now we've got this message for America. Aren't you glad you came?
Oh, I certainly am.
Having a good time?
Definitely.
Good.
Most definitely.
Where are you from, Larry?
Selma, Alabama.
Selma, Alabama.
Yes, I am.
Famous place, isn't it?
Yes, it is.
Yeah. What do you do there, if anything?
Well, I go to school, but yeah. I transfer it out here because I'd like to go to school out here.
You want to mix it up a little bit?
I think the educational level out here would be much better.
Yeah. And what are you studying?
I want to be an elementary ed teacher.
Elementary ed.
Right.
Okay. All right. Good luck to you.
Thank you very much.
Are you ready to begin?
Oh, yes.
All right, Larry, you have a choice of A or B.
A for absolutely.
A for absolutely.
Right.
Good. Think positively, Larry, and you go far. Sid the Sculptor said, "I just went broke buying clay. That's what I get for trying to do a bust of blank." Went broke buying clay. Sid the Sculptor said, "I just went broke buying clay. That's what I get for trying to do a bust of blank."
Dolly Parton.
Dolly Parton. Okay, show us yours, Don.
Ah, yeah.
Yeah. He got the idea. Smart kid.
What did you say, Dolly who? Dolly Madison?
Dolly Parton.
Dolly Parton?
Yeah.
Oh, she's a singer.
Yeah, all three of them.
If you got them, Dolly, show them.
Right, she's got them. She can hardly help showing them.
I went another route.
You did.
Dolly Parton.
Yeah. All roads lead to...
What?
All roads lead to Dolly Parton.
Or a reasonable facsimile.
I just went broke buying clay. That's what I get for trying to do a bust of...
I hate to be a party to all of this, but...
You are.
I figured it was a match.
Nothing wrong?
Well, no,
I
hate to be a partin' to all this, but Dolly Parton.
Okay.
I want to see her. I can't wait to see her. This is the most exciting thing waiting for answers.
That's right, because she's very creative.
I want a copy, but they're so far out, I don't want to... I go to copy. Oh, no, not that one. Do my own. Oh, that's so far out. She's sick is what she's doing. I can't wait to see what she's got. Well, I can see what you've got, but I can't. Sorry, Don, too. Sorry. I'm sorry. Go ahead.
Go.
The King family.
I knew it. See, that's why I didn't copy.
That's what you have for trying to do a bust of the King family.
Yeah, see?
Very good, because there are a lot of bodies involved there. Well, Larry did very well with that.
That's
unusual to do that many in a first round. Let's see how Ambie does with her first round. At the deli now, Harry said to the waiter, "I'll tell you why I want you to take back this soup. Take a look. Since when does a matzo ball have blank?" That's why I want you to take back the soup. Look, since when does a matzo ball have blank already? Okay, here we go. At the deli, Harry said to the waiter, "I'll tell you why I want you to take back this soup. Take a look. Since when does a matzo ball have blank?"
Hair.
Hair. That's good. That's not a
bad answer. Since when does a matzo ball have hair? I think that's quite good.
What this wonderful. May quite possibly be the worst answer you've ever had. I say.
Well, you're entitled because you've getting a lot of good.
Balls and baseball have stitches.
Oh, yeah. Since when does a matzo ball have stitches?
I like stitches.
That's your first boo, Don. Oh. That's his first boo.
It's a cathartic, isn't it?
It is, yes.
Yes.
It feels good.
Yes.
We'll meet
later. Especially when you deserve it. It's wonderful.
Stinks.
Show him a good one.
Well, goodness, I always have awfully good answers. That's an odd, very peculiar answer she had.
Yeah, hair.
It just takes
not
away.
Bad.
Well, no, it takes away your appetite. Something sort of
oh,
disgusting.
Oh, yeah, that's why you wanted to send the
hair.
Soup. The hair, there. Okay.
This is pretty close, kids. Think about it carefully. What is young hair called?
How would you know?
Fuzz or baby hair.
Fuzz. I lost my hair in the high school fire 3 years ago.
You wish!
The crepe paper decorations were burning and they fell on my forehead.
You lost it 30 years ago. High school fire.
Brett, you're getting hysterical. I mean, it's all right to put them down, but easy, gently. Hello there. The waiter says, guy says, I'll tell you what, take back the soup. Since when does a matzo ball have hair? You don't like it?
Matzo ball has legs.
Legs?
Would you go for hairy legs?
I like it.
Hairy legs. Hairy legs are in?
Hairy legs.
They're not good. Hairy legs are out.
No,
hey,
they
shave
legs.
More
no,
hairy.
No, no but
well,
you see, she shaves her legs.
Oh, I shave legs. Oh, you shaved your legs? Oh,
yeah.
Well, the day's off tonight.
All right, Bill.
I put, what was wrong, I had two legs, two arms, and if you've been, and a nose job. That's what they had on.
Two legs, two arms,
had a nose, job because it was matzo balls.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, that's another worst.
Oh, wait for her, though. Yeah. She'll get me. She'll get us out of this.
Oh, sure. Count on me for the saver, huh?
And I copied that from her, no.
A number 8 on the side.
A number 8 on the side? Since when does a matzo ball have a number 8 on the side? Excellent answer.
Excellent.
So the waiter was behind the 8 ball, nothing he could do. 5-2 the score, the end of round 1. Round 2 coming up later now, then. Here we go to round 2. Larry, A or B?
A.
A for absolutely. One person plays.
Guess.
Yes.
Guess.
Which one? Just which one plays in this panel?
Yes.
The one that missed it the last time.
The lady with the genuine red hair.
Getting on you? Wow. I got it all on me too. Really.
Hey, as long as you have your health, you know what I mean?
Yeah, sure. Not for long.
Oh, okay.
What disease you selling this year?
Your name will be that.
Wally the weatherman said there's only one thing worse than a cold front.
Uh-huh.
A cold blank.
Fill it in here.
Yeah, only one thing worse than a cold front. Yeah, you can fill it in there. Write it in there. No, you better not, because I have to take it back from there.
Did you put in your drink waters yet?
Yeah. Good cheese, burgers,
yeah. Cheese. Yeah.
What do you want, fries?
Vodka tonic.
Tippy coffee, no sugar.
A little lime. Yeah, right. Yeah. Here we go. Over to Larry Carter. Wally the weatherman said there's only one thing worse than a cold front, a cold blank.
Bottom,
he says. Okay, Patty. There's only one thing worse than a cold front, a cold bottom. Show us your bottom.
Also known as your back end.
Aha! There it is. Okay, now he's got 6 means you've got to match all 4 remaining ones to stay in the game right now. This for you. Now, wait a minute. Now, let's see. What is the date of this show, approximately? What?
Who knows?
Oh, I know that. I checked that out. I'll be in Albuquerque, and this will be gone at the same time in Albuquerque. And then I'm going to be in Baltimore and Cockeyville, which is really the name of town. And this will also be on.
Now,
so
wait,
what are you going to be doing?
My play called Lover's Leap. Real fast. I've got to see it real fast.
No, and it's all right. Lover's Leap.
I can talk slowly?
Yeah. Just talk slowly. Yeah. Albuquerque, what's the date?
Albuquerque, New Mexico. I don't know, but sometime. I think it's about 4 years from now, but I just want to plug it. I never plugged anything in the show. No, I'm going to open up an album.
Lover's Leap.
Look for
Bill Daly in Lover's Leap. He's wonderful at a party. He wrote it. He's terrific.
I'm really doing it.
Now, next time we get together, these are the stars we'll have.
Fred Grandy. Brett Summers. Charles El Serrano. Connie Stevens. Bill Cullen and Marcia Wallace.
Team Raider, join us next time for Match Game 79.